of old grave. It's nothing but grace. The grace of God. Grace come. The unmerited grace of God. You can't buy it. You can't earn it. God's grace is just like favor. God's grace is unfair. It's like favor is unfair. I'm glad that His grace keep me every day. I'm glad that I serve a graceful God that keep looking. Because of grace, He keep looking beyond my faults. He keep supplying my needs. Because of grace, sometimes God don't give me what I want, but He gives me what I need. Paul said, Lord, if you take this thorn away from me, please, please take it away. For I came to you 3 times and you hadn't moved it. Three stands for that which is whole. Three stands for that which is solid. Three, there's something strange and unusual about the number three. It was Jesus who came to this world and died when He was 33 years old. It was Jesus. They hung Him high and they stretched Him wide. He hung from the 6th to the 9th hour. That's three. And when He died, they put Him in a grave. One for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Ghost. And something happened that Saturday night, early Sunday morning. He got up, and I'm so glad that He got up in my life. When I was big enough and bad enough to do what I wanted to do, but one day Christ got up, and when He got up, He stood up and declared that all power is in my hand. I'm glad that God got the power to go with me to the end. I'm glad that God got the power. See, God the power got the power. But there's no power like God got. God got the power because everything moving by the power of God. I woke up this morning, not by my powers. I know I look good and I know I'm fine, but I didn't wake up because of that. I woke up by the power of God. I can move my hand. I can have my being because of the power of God. I got power, Holy Ghost power, that power that will make you do right. I'm glad when He got up, He had the power to bring that child who gone astray. God got so much power to bring that child back home. That husband that don't want to do right, just turn him over and put him in God's hand. Don't you try to fuss and fight with him. Because if you fuss and fight with him, God ain't got to do His part. But you did your part. Just put him in God's hand. That woman you running behind, put her in God's hand. And everything, even that child who keep you at the schoolhouse, every 5 minutes the teacher calling, put it in God's hand. See, I learned to put this and that. And that, I put it all in God's hand. See, in His hand, oh, He got the whole world in His hand. He got the little bitty baby in His hand. He got Odum grown in His hand. He got you and me, brother, in His hand. He got you and me, sister, in His hand. Who can pluck you out? That's why I'm glad that I'm on God's team. I'm glad that I'm trusting God. I don't care where I'm at. I don't know the land or the raging sea. But my God, He cares about me. Can I tell you something? Be not dismayed. Whatever betide you, God will. God will. and over. The more I praise him, the better I feel. The better I feel, the more I praise him. The more I praise him, the better I feel. The better I feel, the more I praise him. The more I praise him, the better I feel. You ought to clap your hands. You ought to stomp your feet.
Late.
next week. But sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes the ways get rough. Sometimes the going get tough. But I learned, if I never had a problem, I wouldn't know that he can solve them. But that let me know what my faith in God can do. Because through it all, I've learned to doubt. I've learned to trust in Jesus.